So we have Robert Schiele talking about ERPM sync, and Hudi and myself will be talking about some download.opensuse.org stuff, how to improve the mirror situation and things like that. So just go ahead, Robert.
Okay, you all know the most important part of the talk is the title, and so I found an interesting one. I want to talk today about what, in my opinion, when does not work with the current DRPM sync. Everybody that has tried it outside of SUSE has experienced some problems, and I will explain what the reasons are for that, in my opinion, and how can they be solved. So, because I use this logo, I have also this legal disclaimer. I was asked to add some information about that. And now listen and repeat, this is only my opinion and not an official opinion of any of those mentioned people. So, can we continue? So, what's wrong with the current protocol of DRPM sync? So, if you try it, you find that it does not scale. That does mean if you run it on your computer, you get somewhat about 10 kilobytes per second, and if you look at the size of the repository, it's about 30 gigabytes, and then you can calculate how long it might take until you have completed the sync. Even if you have deltas, well, then it's a bit faster, but it still needs some about 3 days or something like that. And SUSE can produce new packages faster than you can download them, even if you only don't download the deltas. So this is not really a problem of the protocol, but of the tool acceptance. The tool acceptance, especially by mirror admins. If there were enough mirrors of this DRPM sync service everywhere around, that should work. But actually they aren't. And so there's only one mirror server, or only one server, the official server of SUSE in public. And this server is pretty low because it also provides some other services, and it has a certain bandwidth limit, and so it can only provide at about 10 or 20, sometimes 20 kilobytes per second. So the protocol as it is currently is not ready for the real world. It works in a special situation where we have good bandwidth connections, but it does not work outside. So how can we solve that? Here I will tell how I did solve that with a tool I have written. The first thing I did, I was permanently annoying Christoph and was whining about the badness of the world, but unfortunately that did not help. So, next step. I tried to teach the RPM sync to fetch the deltas from an alternative server, but Michael somehow missed to document some functions and so it was a bit difficult.
It's probably not need to document protocol.
Okay. You never need, yeah.
The semantics were not that clear for every function, so I thought I will first try to do an alternative proof of concept implementation, and I called that my DRPM sync because it's mine, but you can change that name if you don't like it. So now, what is about that tool? The first thing, I think, is you can use all rsync servers that have the deltas mirrored from the DRPM sync service. And there are some. And so we can use the established mirror infrastructure, and we don't rely on other DRPM sync servers being around all over the world. Sure, we need the meta information from the main server, but only the meta information, not the deltas themselves. The second thing is I made that client multi-threaded. That means I can use multiple processors for applying the deltas, and I can use multiple network connections if I have some mirrors or something to have a better bandwidth connection. And then another thing is that many people don't need all the packages. The standard DRPM sync service just mirrors the whole repository. And if someone has only a 32-bit Intel machine at home, he doesn't need the PowerPC packages and he doesn't need the 64-bit packages for the AMD system. And so he can just deselect them. Or maybe he doesn't need the sources, he doesn't need the debug info packages and all that stuff. He just deselects that. Or he can use a custom filter to filter out some packages he doesn't want to. For example, if someone likes KDE, he doesn't want GNOME packages or the other one, way around or whatever. And another thing I did is that the client is quite robust. The problem with the other client is if there is a problem with the server, he stops with an error message. And if you have large data to collect, I think it's more useful to just skip that step first and download the other stuff, and later you can then look at the problem and fix that so that your download isn't broken because there's some problem with the server. So, are there other alternative solutions to solve these problems? What I also thought about is the reason why Magnum Mirror admins don't want this tool is that they say, we use rsync for everything, and so we don't want another tool. So what could be done is first to make this a bit clean, implement a plugin infrastructure in rsync to handle specific files with specific algorithms. Normally, rsync just checks, does some checksum calculations, and only mirrors that parts that differ if you have already an old version of that file. The problem is that this does not help very much with RPM because in RPM the payload is compressed and thus these checksum calculations are almost every time incorrect and it doesn't work. So if you did that, you could implement the algorithm that the RPM sync is using as such a plugin for rsync. And then rsync will handle the normal files as it did every time before, and it will handle these packages with the algorithm as the current RPM sync tool does as well. And then the first step, which is also important, this all helps only if you manage to convince the mirror admins to use this new version of rsync. If you don't manage to do that, it won't help. So, how to improve the current protocol? In my opinion, only if you have only a very low number of the RPM sync servers, they should have a mode where they only distribute the metadata and the other stuff is taken from other servers. For example, rsync, FTP, or whatever you like. And there's a problem, which Michael also mentioned to me, but there might be an inconsistency between the mirrors. It might be that one mirror has not catched up to the RPM sync server, and so you can't fetch the deltas from this mirror. And this is a real problem, but I think Christoph will tell something about that. There's this download.opensuse.org server, which knows which mirror servers have already mirrored some files, and maybe that could be used in connection with this system to check which mirror server does have this, and you can ask this special UDR PM sync server, I want this delta, and I want it from any server, and this service then does give you a hint where you could download this patch. And then you can collect it from a fast mirror and only have to ask the central server about the location of the patch, which is then much faster, at least I think so. So, finally, you may want to ask some questions, give some comments, or some rants or something. You can either do that here, or you can do that by sending me an email. Yes.
Right. So, rather than convincing all the mirror maintainers to switch to your favorite method of replicating copies, why don't you set up your own kind of mirror somewhere at an ISP and do it the proper way, the way you want it, and just get it done?
Well, the problem is if you need a mirror that with high bandwidth, mirrors with high bandwidth, you either have to pay very much money, or you are at an institution where you have the infrastructure. For example, you in Germany, it's this, at home, where I come from in Germany, the universities have very good bandwidth, and I think it's maybe the same in Belgium or anywhere else.
So what you've been trying to convince mirror maintainers to switch to that system, send them an email? Send an email
I think it does only work if you know these people.
Exactly, that's my point. So get them together, do a conference, invite them, give them a free t-shirt, make them happy, give out cookies, warm milk, and do it from there.
This is a step that must be taken, but I think it's easier to do that if you have some tools that are similar to those tools they are used to.
Definitely, but you need to get at them. And I don't think sending them email or hoping they might come to this conference and hear your talk is working.
Well, we are working with our administrators to use DRPM Sync, but it's not that easy. I have talked to Ivan Mönkebeck, for example, who's doing FTP GDE, for a couple of times, and he refused to use it.
So there's one out, but...
Yeah, he's not out, but I think maybe sooner or later he will use it, but it needs lots of time to convince him that it's a good idea.
I think you should get them in and do a workshop and maybe ask them to present their side of the whole thing to you. I mean, get in a Beamer, let him sit down, log in, show his kind of work environment, and I guess that's the main thing that you need to know about this. So, switching some part of the system takes a lot of talking. So rather than talking, let them do the talk, and maybe you see how you fit in to that kind of system.
Okay, that's right what you say. What I wanted to do here as well is to show that there is a tool, and I hope that some people try this tool I have written and see what is better or what is better with the other tool that is there.
Admins don't test. Admins work.
Yeah, but other users, currently we have the situation that we don't have mirrors of that for that system, and so currently we have to use another tool because the other one does not really work because it's too slow. And so if some interested users are interested in mirroring the factory distribution, they could use that tool and give feedback, and that's also helpful for improving this tool or for merging it with the tool Mika has made.
The point is probably that the admins tell us that the tool isn't used and the users don't use it because
they use it.
Yeah, but because if they use it, it's that slow because we don't have a good mirror structure. So, yeah, kind of deadlock here.
And so we have to start with something that does not rely on having an infrastructure in the first place, because we have to start that process somehow.
Yeah, another problem is that in a lot of institutions you cannot add an extra service without going through a security review or something like that. So this is an extra service, and Mirror admins will have to convince their bosses to actually have it running on their servers and stuff like that. So it's not that easy.
There is. So how many more speed talks do you have? Because one third of the time is gone, I guess.
Yeah, we have two. But we managed. Right.
Okay.
Because we have, Stefan told me we'll have more time because his talk is a bit shorter. Yeah. So no time to worry. Yeah. No need to worry.
Good. Any questions or next one?
Next.